In this video, I'll be sharing with you step by step this exciting scholarship by the Polish government. So if you're interested to be in Poland 2023-2024 section, watch this video till the end. This scholarship is open to all international students from developing countries to study full-time degree programs at any government university for free. Hi, my name is Sylvia. Subscribe to the channel and turn on your notification bell. Also like and share this video with your family and friends.
This particular scholarship is called the Stefan Banach Scholarship Program. This is two separate scholarships that joined to become one. So this Lukasz and Banach now formed Stefan Banach Scholarship. It covers a lot of scholarships for both bachelor's, master's, and doctoral students, as well as scientists. Objective of this program is to promote socioeconomic progress of developing countries, and the maximum number of applications is just one. So please do not apply to more than one scholarship. The NAWA Scholarship is for citizens of this following country: Albania, Angola, Argentina, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Belarus, Bosnia, Brazil, Colombia, Ethiopia, Georgia, India, Indonesia, Iraq, Iran, Jordan, Kazakhstan, Kenya, Kosovo, Lebanon, Mexico, Moldova, Montenegro, Nigeria, North Macedonia, Palestine, Peru, the Philippines, Senegal, Serbia, South Africa, Tanzania, Tunisia, Ukraine, Uzbekistan, and Vietnam. When you scroll down, you can see the list of required attachments. So you need to scan your valid passport, your diploma, and also when you scroll down, you also need scan of a document confirming the knowledge of Polish or English, so depending on what you have. And here you need a recommendation letter. And I think that's just basically it. This program offers a monthly scholarship for the duration of your studies. And here there's also an exemption from tuition fees at the public university. Scholarship amount is 1,700 Polish zloty per month during the preparatory course, if you are going to be choosing the preparatory course, or 1,500 per month during the second cycle, during your main studies. As well, you're going to be receiving in the first year of your studies a monthly scholarship increased by 1,000 or by 3,000 according to the country you come from. And on the last year of your studies, you'll be getting your scholarship increased by 500 Polish zloty. Basically, in Poland, their cost of living is very low in comparison to other European countries. So this is why this amount is really very okay for a student per month in Poland. Also, during the summer break, a lot of students, depending on where your university is bordered, come to either Germany or Czech to do their summer job so that they can also make more money. Here it says that the results of the call for proposal shall be announced by the end of July. And here in the attachments, you can click any of these to see the list of certificates that they require concerning English language. And here is the link that shows the mother certificates. And here is the link that shows the list of country and corresponding rates. So here is the mobility allowance. So when I click on this link, let's see the mobility allowance according to country. So depending on your country, this is going to be your mobility allowance. So for example, if you're from Azerbaijan, you're going to receive 3,000 Polish zloty. Or you're from India, you'll be receiving 3,000. From Lebanon, 3,000. If you're from Nigeria, 3,000. If you're from Tunisia, 3,000. So yeah, it all depends. So you're going to be looking through this to know what will be your allowance. For us to know more what this program entails, let's click on this more information. So on this page, feel free to change to any language that you feel comfortable in. Basically, that this particular scholarship is for those in the fields of engineering and technical sciences, agricultural science, exact sciences, and life sciences. So if you're in any of these fields, you are free to apply to this particular scholarship in either Polish or in English. When you scroll down, you can click on any of these links to learn more, call for proposal, the documents that you need, information that you need. I'm going to click on call for proposal. Here, for us to make this application, you're going to click on fill in the application. Please give this video a big thumbs up if you like it and share it with your family and friends. Brings you to this page where you're going to be creating an account. So do well to change it to English Or if you're comfortable in Polish, then you can also continue. But I'm going to change it to English. So now you fill in your details like so, and then you accept the regulations and you click on create account. And here it says, thank you for your registration. You have to go to the email to get the activation link. This is my mail. And now I click on this. And here I have to click on this activation link. Automatically, it lands me to this page. So this is where I'll be making this application. Now you can see the Polish National Agency for Academic Exchange. It explains to you what this means. One is where you're going to be making the application. And two is the application tab where you'll be seeing all your documents. And three is where you'll be selecting the documents to upload. And four is where you'll be seeing important information about your application. And five is your profile in case you want to update or complete any data later. And six is question and answer. So basically, they have simplified everything for you. And once you're done reading this, you just click on close guide. So here you can see different programs. You have program for students, for scientists, institution, experts, if you want to learn Polish language, and also university registration. So depending on what you're looking for, you can feel free to click on any of these programs and explore. So let's see what they have for students. So here you can see these two programs are currently in recruitment. So the deadline is going to be in 28 days for this one. And also this one is going to be in 77 days. So feel free to open any of them to explore. But right now I'm going to click on this one to explore more. But if not, you can also click immediately to fill out the application. But let's click on more. There are several programs that are ongoing based on this scholarship NAWA. This is program for students and doctoral students. This is also for students and doctoral students. So you can also see the expiry date, April 28th. You can also see this one expiring May 22nd, program for scientists. There are basically a lot of programs here. So you just have to do well to open each of them to see what it's all about and see what suits your interest. So they have a lot of program on. And when you click on the next page, there are a lot of programs that are for scientists here. So feel free to forward this message to anyone you know that are scientists, but basically you can open each of them to explore on any of those. Let us see the details on this one for cycle studies and uniform master studies. The deadline is going to be July 11th. So click on the details. It simply says the event date is the March 29th. The end date is July 11, 2023. So if you want to know more about this particular program, you will simply click on this link to direct you to know more. So once you're satisfied and you want to apply for this particular scholarship, you will just simply click on this, fill out the application. Here you can see the scholarship program, and here you take your time and read through this before you make the application. Like they said, on the left, you can see the five tabs you need to go through. So when I click on the applicant's data, it brings you automatically to this page where you're going to read through, and then you fill carefully everything marked in asterisks and put in all the necessary information. Once you're done filling the first one, you click on this arrow tab to take you to the next column. So basically, it's going to be directing you and you would be seeing everything. So here you're going to select the university. If you already have university in mind, you select them. And yes, these are all important fields that you would fill. Take your time, go through it and see what's peculiar to you and fill it accordingly. For any reason during this particular application, you need to contact them. You can write an email to this email address. This is their number to contact. I encourage you strongly to write them an email if you're having any doubts regarding any information or any issue whilst making your application. This is pretty much it. Please subscribe to the channel if you have not done so. Like and share this video for others to benefit from it. Drop your comments and concerns and I will respond to each of them. And with this, I want to say thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.